her debut. Woo-hoo! Congratulations. We're the first Meera and Muzaffar, and we have the pleasure of having dear, dear Aditi walk the ramp. आप पूछेंगे कि बेगानी शादी में अब्दुल्ला जी गाना मैं क्यों ये प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस होल्ड कर रहा हूं, इट्स ओनली टू टीज थिंग्स आउट एंड टू टेल यू दैट मुजफ्फर हैज बीन अ वेरी क्लोज फ्रेंड फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम एंड ऑफ कोर्स आल्सो मीरा. आई हैव सीन द वंडरफुल वर्क मुजफ्फर हैज डन विद क्राफ्ट. वी हैड द प्लेजर ऑलमोस्ट 30 इयर्स अगो फॉर मेकिंग अ फिल्म कॉल्ड अंजुमन व्हिच डेल्ट विद द प्लाइट ऑफ द चिकन वर्कर्स. So Muzaffar in his work has shown both his concern, his sensitivity and his empathy to the craftspeople. I always say that in India, if you're looking at silhouettes, it's something that the West can probably do better than us. But what they can't do definitely is handwork. And that's what we need to take to them. I think it's a matter of great pride that Sama takes this tradition forward and tweaks it like the young people. I'll first give it to Sama and then everybody else.
Hi everyone, thank you for being here. And I'd like to thank my parents for, well, you know, just for being born in their home and hence having this opportunity at this stage in life. And I hope you all enjoy watching the show. Something that's been really important to me growing up, it's been quite ingrained in my upbringing is the concern for handcrafts, not just from a, you know, from the perspective of like just beautiful art that you wear on your body, but also from the perspective of just touching people's lives, from the people who make them, the people who wear them. And how it's really important that the people who wear them don't forget why, what effort has gone into the, you know, making them look good. It's not just superficial. Fashion is not superficial. It's the second largest employer in our country after agriculture, and we have to acknowledge that and improve the lives of those who make these clothes. And that's what is really important to all of us, and this is something we try to show in the clothes, that you can have traditional clothes and they can still fit in our modern globalizing lives, you know, where nobody really wears traditional clothes the way they used to anymore. So how do we take our heritage in embroideries and handwork and put it into a context that we can continue to enjoy going into the future and share with the rest of the world?
Anybody want to ask anything specific? I think everything has been said. I think let's ask Aditi why she agreed to be with us today and wear this and look so beautiful in it.
I've actually always wanted to be associated with Kutwara. I know Shabala Vasi has been associated with the family, has worked with them. It's also been my dream to be in some way associated with us, because they believe so much in the revival of handicrafts, in like Sama said, in making it a part of our everyday. And I think for handicrafts, you know, to not be locked up in a cupboard and for it to be a part of our everyday is really important for us to wear it with pride, for us to realize how much it enriches our lives. I think that is what makes the difference. And if we can do that, then nobody will ever tell us that, you know, it's a dying art or it's, you know, we need patrons for it. We ourselves have it within us to do that by making it a part of our everyday lives. And I think Kotwara is so much about heritage and legacy, and for me to have been a part of the to have been a part of this show is special, because Sama was so deeply involved and this is her first show. So it was very special for me, and this collaboration meant a lot to me. So I'm very, very happy to be here today. And I wish that I could dress like this every day.
I think handicraft is a way of life. And you have to be obsessed with handicraft and anything that is made by your hands. And you need a very deep respect for it. It's almost a spiritual feeling, you know. Handicraft is one of the most spiritual ways of touching people. It's very, you see what happened in Kashmir. One Sufi brought 1200 craftsmen and it has changed the face of the valley. So it's got so much barakat in it that we can't imagine what it can do for the country, what it can do for the people. And this is what I felt through all my art, how to touch people and how to make a difference. And through my films, I've been led to craft. Because when you dress people in a film, you're showing the truth, you're showing a slice of reality. And handicraft is all about taking small steps. It's not creating a big revolution. It's just about taking gentle steps, making people sensitive to their legacy, what comes out of your mother's cupboard or your trunks. To be sensitive to that is very important. And to live with little, small little details of craft is a big joy, you know. If you start living with small little elements of craft, you feel rich every day. You know, like I'm wearing this, nobody knows what's inside my pocket. But I know it's a piece of craft, you know. So it's just to feel it. And it's just a reminder for me that human effort is so valuable, so tender, and the craftsman doesn't see beyond his needle. It's you who has to design his life, design what he does. And there's such a nice, beautiful upsurge in this field that it needs to be celebrated.